Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you horizontal micro instructions and vertical micro instructions in micro programmed control unit. Here you should know with micro program control unit, when you execute one instruction, that one instruction is a combination of multiple micro operations. And those micro operations are performed by micro instructions. So what should be the format of those micro instruction? That has been divided into two parts, horizontal micro instruction and vertical micro instruction. I'll explain you how exactly those instructions are formed. The reason is when it comes to competitive examination at that time, there is a possibility of many questions based on this, right? So here what I'll do is I'll explain you the basic understanding of how horizontal micro instruction is there and how vertical micro instruction is there. Let us talk about first, what is horizontal micro instruction? So here, my dear students, when we talk about horizontal micro instruction, then with that instruction, every bit of micro instruction corresponds to control signal. So micro instructions bit that will define control signals directly, right? So based on the value of instructions bit, it will be generating control signals. Let me show you how. For example, here we are having one micro instruction that is having 4 bits. C0, C1, C2, C3. So these 4 bits that will be generating control signals directly. You should know, my dear students, to have any micro operations, CPU will have to generate control signals, right? So in horizontal micro instruction, you will be having one control word. That control word will define control signals directly, right? For example, if 4-bit control word is there, then it will be generating 4 control signals at the same time. Now, why it is referred as horizontal micro instruction? The reason is, as if you want to generate more control signals, then what you need to do? If you want to generate more control signals, then you'll have to expand the memory horizontally, you see. As if you want to generate more control signals, then what you need to do? You need to expand the memory horizontally. That's why it is referred as horizontal micro instruction. So simply you can understand this in this way. The number of bits will define number of control signals, right? That is horizontal micro instruction. So as if you want to expand number of control signals, then you'll have to expand memory horizontally. Means control word size that will be widened over here. Let us try to understand what will happen with vertical micro instruction now. So in vertical micro instruction, you'll be observing every bit of micro instruction will have to get decoded first to have a generation of control signals. Let me show you how. For example, here we have vertical micro instruction. In that, you see, we are having 4 bits, C0, C1, C2, C3. But this is not giving you control signal directly. Here, after this, you'll be using one decoder. And decoder will decode this, and based on that, it will be generating control signals. So here, my dear students, for example, if you want to have 16 control signals, then with vertical micro instruction, you will be using vertical structure. In vertical structure, only 4 bits will be there in instruction. And after that, by having a decoder, you will be generating 16 control signals, right? So here, my dear students, just try to understand one thing. If you want to generate more control signals, what you are doing? You are expanding circuit vertically. Right, that's why it is referred as vertical micro instruction. But here, there are few basic things that you can directly understand. First is, in horizontal micro instruction, it is directly generating control signals, so obviously it will be fast. With vertical micro instruction, you'll have to decode those bits, so decoder will be used. Right, after that it will be generating control signals, so obviously it will be slow. But there are few more things. See, here, let us say we are having 4 control signals. Immediately it is generating it, it is fast, okay. All 4 control signals, those are happening at the same time. All 4 control signals are happening at the same time. I'm repeating it again. So at a time, 4 control signals are there. While with vertical micro instruction, you see what is happening. 4 bits are there, but it is decoded to 16 bits, right? And then you'll be having control signals. But at a time, it is only generating one control signal. Decoder cannot provide 16 control signal at a time. Otherwise, you can say, okay, vertical micro instruction is faster compared to horizontal. As if it is providing 16 control signals at a time. It is not providing like this. It is just providing one control signal at a time. But number of control signals available over here, those are 16, right? So vertical micro instruction structure will be always slow. Why? The reason is it is vertically oriented. Here we need to provide decoding operation. So as if you have many control signals, then you should go for vertical structure. As if you have less number of control signals, then you should go for horizontal. Why? The reason is if you expand size horizontally in control memory, then control memory will become large. Main cost is what? Control memory only, right? Major cost is what? Control memory only. Again, I'm saying you, what is the major cost? Control memory only. So control memory defines the cost. So horizontal micro instruction, as if you have wide instruction, then cost will be also high, right? And to have lower cost, what we should do? Vertical structure. But vertical structure is slow. So that is how trade-off is there. There is a solution for that. That is what I'll be explaining you in next video by having nano programming. But here you just need to understand how things are there. Let us compare both of these categories along with parameters, so that when it comes to solving questions, at that time it will be easier for you, right? So here let us compare both by various parameters. So when it comes to control signal generation, then every bit of micro instruction, of horizontal micro instruction, that is giving you control signal, right? But with vertical micro instruction, you need to decode that first. After that only you will be having control signals. You will be observing, you need to have decoding operation in vertical structure. In horizontal structure, you don't need it, as micro instruction itself gives you control signals, right? Here, when it comes to number of signals generated in a single micro instruction execution, then there will be multiple control signals over here, right? As it is directly giving control signals over here with instruction itself. But with vertical structure, you'll be having only one control signal. Obviously, number of control signals will be more, but at a time, only one control that will be provided over here. Remember this, right? When it comes to memory, then obviously horizontal micro instruction needs larger size of memory. Why? The reason is it is expanded horizontally over here. So more the number of control signals, larger the size of memory requirement over here. But with vertical structure, you need less memory only. And just think about this, like if you want to have 32 control signals, then 32 control signals with vertical structure, that will be happening by 5 bits only, 2 to the power 5, 32. So 5 bit micro instruction can generate 32 control signals, right? It is not like at a time 32 control signals. It is like total 32 control signals are there, out of which any one can be provided, right? But with 32 control signal with horizontal, you will have to have 32 bit size of horizontal memory. So you just think about this, why we should be having horizontal and vertical structure, right? So here, when it comes to execution speed, obviously horizontal will be way fast compared to vertical, right? And when it comes to control word size, then control word size, that is there based on horizontal expansion only. So number of control signals will define size of control word over here, while control word size, that is short over here, right? The reason is decoding operation is happening. So in short, my dear students, when it comes to problem solving, at that time, first of all, you need to understand the format of instruction. Once you understand the format of instruction, you can easily calculate any question based on horizontal or vertical structure. So in future coming videos, I'm going to explain you many problems based on this. That will definitely open up your mind, and you can easily solve any question based on any examination. It may be GATE, it may be university examination. Many of my students are saying like, sir, is it based on university examination? Is it based on GATE examination? Why you are thinking in that way? I'm not getting it. Like say university examination and GATE examination and any examination, content remains same. Only thing is you'll have to do some practice, some example solving practice. Everything is same. It is not like you should go for any GATE course or something like that. But still, if you want to do those things, it is your choice. I'm not saying you to purchase any GATE course, right? Even I'm not promoting my course. I'm having courses, but I have never promoted those things. Thank you so much for watching this video.